the confusion with regard to the COVID-19 pandemic, if you want to call it that, continues on and on. It's true, the president hasn't done a good job in managing the pandemic. We have to be candid about that. A new message every single day. But can you imagine what would happen if Joe Biden became president? Yesterday, he made a moronic statement. I mean, a brain-dead, moronic statement that but for Trump, no one would have been killed. I'm paraphrasing. I mean, what a moron. And of course, the left doesn't do much about it. They just go on and on and on. The guy is not capable of being president. He simply has the onset, most likely, of Alzheimer's. You'll get Kamala Harris if he dies. He will surely die in office if he makes it as far enough as the election. And I don't wish him any harm, although I do have a lawsuit against him where I do wish him harm in Boca Raton, Florida, where he interfered with my YouTube channel a while back. And I'll be cranking that lawsuit up just in the next few weeks. But I got to tell you something here. I mean, this country is hanging by a thread, and that's the best way you can put it. The leftist media is vicious and vile and disgusting. The right doesn't tell the truth, and I'm talking about the right of Fox News, because, you know, we have two coronavirus class actions. Tucker Carlson, who frankly is a two-faced, dishonest individual. He's bright. I give him that. He's bright, but he also is two-faced and dishonest. I have a long history with him as well as Hannity. Doesn't mention that, in fact, someone's trying to do something about the coronavirus to get compensation for everybody in this country who have been harmed. We have class actions in Dallas, Texas. We also have a class action in Jerusalem, Israel. That, of course, applies to the Israelis. We have a very good law firm there that's our partner. But I want to know why the media, frankly, is irresponsible, lies, or omits facts. You know, omitting facts also constitutes lying. And that's why Tucker Carlson is a liar. But there are a lot of other people out there as well. We just don't want to single him out. People don't get the correct information. And that's why it's important to listen to this podcast. I tell it like it is. I don't pull any punches. I don't try to kiss anybody's derriere. I'm trying to talk to you, the American people, because you need to wake up. You need to get up off the couch and you need to do something. Simply reelecting President Trump is not going to do it. I've said personally, I support him. I said personally, I will vote for him. I can't say that as the head of a public interest group, but that's the case. What's the alternative? And he has done some very good things with Israel and the Middle East and in this country, and I give him credit for that. What I don't give him credit for is hanging around people, low lives, like Roger Stone, like Michael Caputo, like Michael Cohen, now who's written a book and shoved it up the president's derriere, and these people. You know, he's got to move on. He's got to grow up. He's got to mature, because unless he does, particularly in the next several weeks, we're going to wind up with Joe Biden and Kamala Harris as our president, because things are not looking good. And all this nonsense about, from the Attorney General of the United States bar, taking strong action against the domestic rioters, the domestic terrorists in the street, we don't have any evidence that he locked up more than a few people, because if he did, the left would be screaming. This is a giant charade. The American people are being deceived. We are lied to every single day by every political party, by every media organization, and I'm tired of it. I've written a book. It's called Essays of a Madman. It's the compilation of all my columns throughout the years. You can get that by going to freedomwatchusa.org. But I've also written a new book, which has been in me for a very long time, and I finally put it in writing. It's called It Takes a Revolution, Forget the Scandal Industry. It goes through the rank corruption and deceit of the three branches of government, particularly the federal judiciary. And it tells us how we can clean it up and how we can do something concrete. As I've said before, it's not enough to write a book to make money. Hannity writes his book, Live Free or Die. I call it Live Free or Lie, because it doesn't tell the truth to the American people. It's simply a regurgitation of his nightly monologues, which are the same monologues over and over again with a few words changed, ending with the Democrats are going to throw Granny over the cliff. The same guests, you know, some of them have cleavages, so they, like Sarah Carter, that's about all she's got going for her. And the others on there haven't done anything. But it's time for you to do stuff. You, the American people. That's why I'm critical. That's why, you know, sometimes I sound like I'm angry, because we don't have a lot of time. These domestic terrorists, if and when Trump wins, are going to tear down our democracy. Every city in this country is going to be burning, and we need to have people who can fight back. I've said, go to freedomwatchusa.org. Listen to Alan Keyes last week on the radio show and a podcast. The president, when there's an insurrection and state and local officials do nothing, has the authority legislatively to take control, to even take control of the police departments, to put this down. He needs to show leadership. President Reagan wouldn't have tolerated this for 24 hours. Remember what he did with the air traffic controllers? They defied him. He dismissed them within minutes. We need someone who just doesn't talk, but someone who acts. And if the president does act, he will win in an overwhelming landslide. Now, I'll talk straight. I'll talk up to him. I haven't talked to him in 4 years, probably because Roger Stone's disparaged me. You know, we have six lawsuits against Roger Stone in the courts for defaming Dr. Jerry Corsi and me. I have a long history with him. I don't need to go through it. But the president simply needs to do it on his own. You need to contact him at the White House. You need to tell him, you know, shape up or ship out, because Biden is playing a game here. They've got a lot of money. They're doing a lot of advertising. And frankly, most Americans, regrettably, are not well-educated, and they may take this hook, line, and sinker. And what do we wind up with? Someone that's going to open the door to socialism and communism and all kinds of other things, who says that China's just a competitor. The communist Chinese are not just a competitor. The communist Chinese are very smart. They want to destroy us. The Russians want to destroy us. The Iranians hate us even more in terms of their Islamic jihad, their way of thinking. We right now need to have a stable country, and we don't have it. And that's why the American people must rise up. I want you to listen to my weekly broadcast, our radio show, Special Prosecutor with Larry Klayman. You can find it on over 50 stations throughout the United States, podcast at freedomwatchusa.org, freedomwatchusa.org, radioamerica.com. You can find it on Roku, iTunes, Parler, P-A-L-R-E-R, Facebook, Twitter, all over the place. Dr. Judy Mikovits is going to be on, and she's going to describe the truth about this coronavirus, which no one will tell. And she's been banned from Twitter. So has the Chinese scientist that came forward recently to say it was a bioweapon that was released by the Chinese. This is what I'm talking about. On both sides of the political spectrum, deceit, lies, and no videotape, to make a paraphrase of the former movie. But this is something which the American people get up off the couch, get to work, turn the cable news off, go to freedomwatchusa.org, join our Justice League, or take over up some other worthy cause, although frankly I can't think of another public interest group that really actually does much of anything other than talk, and let's get to work. God bless you. God bless your family. God save America, and we need God's help to do that, but we need to do it on our own with his grace. I'll be back Monday with another special podcast. Until then, listen to my weekly radio show, Special Prosecutor with Larry Klayman. Thank you for listening to me.